Joining us now from the Perth studio is Tom Stynes from Podium Minerals. Tom, welcome. As it's our first time speaking with you, would you start us off with an introduction to the company?
Yeah, good morning and thank you for having me here today. Podium Minerals, we're kind of the new kid on the block in the ASX. We listed only at the end of February this year. We raised $5.5 million in an IPO. We've been very busy since then. We were out in the field. We were drilling within 3 weeks of our ASX listing. We had first drill results within 6 weeks of our ASX listing. And we've been continuing that with news flow through the year. We're new, but we're trying to get some attention on ourselves.
Tell us about your portfolio of assets.
We have a really strong asset base. Our flagship is what we refer to as the Weld Range Complex. The Weld Range Complex is a set of converted mining leases up in the Midwest of Western Australia, within an established mining jurisdiction between Cue and Meekatharra. Within Weld Range, we have an identified zone of extensive PGM, platinum group metal mineralisation, which we refer to as Parks Reef. We'll no doubt discuss that in a little bit more detail. We have other exploration targets within the Weld Range Complex. And we also have a 28% interest in another company which has mining rights to a large nickel cobalt laterite resource within the complex also. We hold 28% of that company. It's called EV Metals. On top of that, probably second cab off the rank for us is an exploration license in the Northern Territory called Highlander. This is a gold prospect with an identified gold mineralization. And we also have some exploration licenses within the Midwest in the nearby vicinity of the Weld Range Complex. These are prospective for gold and base metals. They're early stage for us, but they give us some optionality and allows us to develop a pipeline of projects going forwards.
Well, Tom, you did tease us there about more detail on your flagship Parks Reef within the Weld Range Complex. Tell us about where you're at with that. I know you recently put out a resource estimate.
Yeah, so look, Parks Reef is... I refer to it as brownfields exploration. You know, the reef itself was identified previously through some shallow surface drilling and exploration. But Podium, we've been going in and we've been systematically drilling this deposit for resources. It's a platinum group metal plus base metals deposit. So platinum group metal being platinum, palladium, accompanied with gold. It extends over a strike length of about 15 kilometres. So, you know, what I'd like people to do is just try and visualise, you know, what is 15 kilometres away from them right now, and that'll give you a sense of the potential size of this deposit. It's very thick. The mineralisation, initial estimates of in our exploration target were about 15 metres. The work we've been doing is verifying that. And in fact, we're showing it's potentially thicker also. So it's a very large resource. It's got a very high resource potential. We've started drilling. We've drilled. Our first campaign drilled about just over 2 kilometres of the reef, which is what we created our mineral resource estimate from. We have an estimate of 340,000. We have mineral resource of 340,000 ounces of platinum, palladium, plus gold, plus significant amounts of copper and nickel within our resource estimate. We've recently gone back. We've completed drilling over a second 2 kilometre zone. We've released those results. That was just last week, showing continuity of the same mineralisation we saw in the first section, potentially a little bit thicker. We're working on analysing those drill results at the moment.
What sort of grades are we talking about?
A mineral resource, the average grade within the platinum group metal zone is 1.5 grams per tonne of platinum, palladium and gold. Within that, we have a high grade zone which runs at about 2 grams per tonne. But it's also accompanied by about 0.26% copper, which is quite significant. So this is sort of a high value zone within the resource. But what we're looking at and what potentially differentiates Parks Reef from other PGM resources around the world is the fact that it's near surface. It's shallow. It's very thick, particularly compared with, say, a lot of the Southern African resources, the reef mineralisation there. So our strategy is that we would like to develop an open pit style operation, bulk mining, low mining cost, low capital cost, to bring this project into fruition.
So clearly quite focused on Weld Range Complex. We have noticed that some of your licenses there have come under threat.
I'm not going to say too much about it. We obviously are going through a process on that at the moment. Look, we're not the first person that this has happened to, the first company that's been attracted this sort of attention. It's, we believe, opportunistic. And look, at the end of the day, it appears to be a shortcoming in the regulations that allows other companies to do this. But look, we're going to address it as quickly as we can. But in the meantime, we're 100% confident of our status, our tenure, the strength of our tenure, and we're going to continue with our work programs.
So Tom, at Parks Reef and the wider area, what are those next stages for development and when will they happen?
Yeah, well, as I said, we released some drill results last week. They were for the platinum group metal assays for our second drilling program. I didn't explain, but the way the reef is structured, we have a platinum group metal zone, and then we have what we refer to as a golden base metal zone. The platinum group metal zone, the process we go through is we drill, we assay for the platinum group metals. We then go back and we take the mineralized zones and we assay for the accompanying base metals. So the next step for us will be releasing those results there with the laboratory at the moment. And after that's completed, we'll commence resource modelling for the second part of the reef. As I said, we've released a maiden mineral resource was based on a 2 kilometre zone from our maiden drilling program. We've now drilled a second 2 kilometre zone. We did advise the market where it would be expecting to release that in Q1 next year. So that's our priority at the moment. But looking forwards from that, you know, what we've done to date, you know, we've drilled a bit over 4 kilometres of a 15-kilometre strike. So we've got over 10 kilometres of strike left to drill. You know, we achieved a resource of 340,000 ounces from the first 2 kilometres. We're going to extend that with this second program. But, you know, it's not much of a stretch to say that, you know, it's not going to take too much more drilling and work to get over the magic million ounces for us. So that's an objective. I'm not going to give you a timeline on that at the moment, but fair to say that as soon as we complete this next stage of work, we're going to continue doing what we've been doing and moving forwards.
Tom Stynes, thank you.
Thank you.